Macabre morning, mooks and morons. As you can see by the way Doc is giddier than a prom queen with a poem discount, he's a little excited today.
That's quite the understatement. Today we're getting extra spooky with a classic character of horror who made me the man I am today.
Milhouse?
Don't forget, I pay you.
Don't forget to pay me.
Your check is in the mail and the decorations are up. I thought it would help us get into the spirit of things.
Really? We're finally talking about Spirited Away? I'll get my Miyazaki merch!
Hold your cat buses. We're not talking about anything Miyazaki related today. Besides, if I tried to redesign any of his work, he'd smite me. I want Senpai to notice me, not destroy me.
So what exactly are we talking about today?
Another beloved creation that can be found frequently in every hot topic around the globe.
Well, based on the decorations and the tune you're humming, I'm gonna guess his name rhymes with Smack Jellington?
Nope, though they do share the same director and composer.
Oh, of course! How silly of me! Today we're talking about Corpse Bride! I know what he's talking about, but messing with him is just too much fun! G-Squad!
This month, the patrons chose to vote on redesigning an iconic character from a horror genre.
And when you're up against iconic characters like Freddy Krueger, Pyramid Head, and even Elvira, you gotta be a really beloved character.
Indeed it is. The subject of today's redesign is the title character of a film from the late 80s starring Michael Keaton.
You mean Batman?
No, this character is wild and exaggerated and has an animated series and even a Broadway show.
Are you sure you're not talking about Batman?
Batman! Batman!
Batman! Batman.
There is a song the good folks sing.
Song the good folks sing.
No, this character can only be summoned if you say their name.
So, kinda like Candle Jack.
Beam.
Glad that's done with. Haven't seen that much wax since Madame Two Swords burned down. Still, not as much trouble as our subject could cause.
How so?
Well, this character comes from a world where the afterlife is very bureaucratic with its handling. Lots of paperwork and red tape to deal with.
Oh, I get you, Doc!
Really?
Yeah, we're doing a redesign for Rest in Peace Department!
No, you senile sorceress, I'm talking about Beetlejuice, you ninny! Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice! You knew what it was all along.
Yep.
And you were just messing with me so I'd say it.
Yep.
Oh dear.
Good morning, Internet! Glad to be back in the land of the living. Hey, Doc, glad to see you. Listen, I got this problem. See, it hurts everything when I do this.
I believe you need a therapist.
Yeah, I'm gonna pass on that. Already had my head shrunk before.
Ahem.
Oh, right. Here's those extra tickets for the show. Man, I can't believe you got them that quick. I'd have figured at least 4 more gags.
You were betting with the demonic love child of the genie and the crypt keeper?
Hey, don't be insulting Crypty. We played Jim Mummy on weekend.
We were betting on how long it would take to get you to summon old humbug pants over here.
How do you two even know each other?
Who do you think fixed his head?
And besides, messing with mortals is way too much fun.
Well, Monsieur Cruddy, would you please explain how you plan to improve upon perfection?
I'm going to ignore that crack and focus on the piece.
Well, Beetlejuice has had 3 main designs over the years. the 1988 movie, the 1989 animated series, and the 2018 musical.
And all iterations have kept the schlubby and slovenly appearance. A fast-talking con artist of the dead and general trickster.
What can I say? If it ain't broke, break something else!
Touch my new conditioner, and I'll be sending you to the netherworld piece by piece! One thing that has changed is the emphasis on certain colors alongside the iconic black and white striped suit. With the animated series being more purple and magenta, and the musical being more green.
In this case, we'll be using both colors. Given his inclination to lion scheme, it does give him a sense to have a bit of a more two-faced look.
Along with that, this redesign will be far more bug-like, which for a guy named Beetlejuice just makes the most sense.
One of the main inspirations for this redesign was The Spider and the Fly, specifically the art by Tony DiTerlizzi from the 2002 picture book.
The artwork definitely has a feeling of a Burton movie. Plus, both stories involve schemers trying to trick innocent people to get what they want.
But for this piece, we took inspiration from a variety of different creatures associated as pests. Cockroaches, mosquitoes, locusts, flies, and of course, spiders.
Swanky place you got here, Doc. Love what you did with the rec room.
I don't have a rec room.
You do now. Or rather, every room is now a wrecked room.
If you're quite done with your shtick, mind taking a look at your design?
Hey, don't be like that, Doc. Besides, I think I know exactly what you're looking for.
Looks like something fixed this way comes.
Well, it certainly has some great assets.
Too easy, Doc!
With this redesign, we definitely gave the Bio-Exorcist a far more Burton-esque design, with a jagged and treacherous smile to the lanky limbs that would make even the Pumpkin King himself envious.
The longer body also helps give him a more imposing and frightening visage, less of a slovenly shyster and more of a manipulative monster.
Aw, Doc! Flattery will get you nowhere!
The arm placement as well, with the top set being widespread as if offering something, while the lower set is more scheming, waiting for you to take the bait.
We even included small cobwebs as a reference to Lydia's stunning poncho in the animated series.
Sweet kid!
Yes, in the continuity where you're not a mugging, monstrous malcontent. Now, if you don't mind...
Hang on, Doc. Before we get to the main event, I'd like to try another model on the lot.
Wait, what do you mean by...
Blanky Lemmy! Feels like I'm moving around on stilts. Either way, I can still have some fun with this body.
All right, you had your fun. You got a new look. Now I think it's time you went back to the afterlife.
Are you kidding me? I got a living body and a whole internet of people to mess with. What more could a ghoul ask for?
Sorry, Juicy, but you made me do this.
Whoa, take it easy. You know I can get you backstage passes too.
How about tickets to Hamilton?
Okay, now you're pushing. Do I look like Kevin Bacon?
The sleeper has awakened!
And the juice is on the loose. Thanks for the update. Later!
Now what do you think?
You think I'm qualified?
Crap, cauldrons! How am I supposed to get him back? Doc! You're alive?
Why am I dripping with goo?
Wrong ghost movie, Doc, but we'll fix you up. Hey, Messy!
What's sets, my buds? Oh, Doctor. What happened? You're coated in Beetlejuice.
Actually, it's sandworm slime.
No way! You're dealing with the guru of goo. The guru, if you will, that is clearly Beetlejuice.
Messy, don't say that word.
What, guru?
No,
goo?
No!
Oh, I get it. You don't want me to say Candlejack.
Dreams.